Hello friends, I am Bindu. Today we will study about etiology and pathogenesis of the dental caries. First, we will know about etiology of the dental caries. There is no universally accepted opinion for the etiology of the dental caries. Many theories have evolved through years of investigation and observation. There are some new theories and some old theories. First theory is legend of worm theory. According to this theory, caries is caused by the worms. Second theory is endogenous theory, which includes humeral theory and vital theory. According to humeral theory, dental caries is produced by internal action of acrid and corroding humors. And in vital theory, tooth decay originated like bone gangrene from within the tooth itself. Then the chemical theory and parasitic theory, which comes under the exogenous theory. According to the chemical theory, unidentified chymal agent was responsible for caries. And parasitic theory stated that living microorganism caused the disintegration in both enamel and dentin. Next theory is Miller's chemico-parasitic theory or acidogenic theory. According to this theory, dental decay is a chemico-parasitic process consisting of two stages. The first stage is the decalcification of enamel, which results in its total destruction and decalcification of dentin as a preliminary stage. The second stage is the dissolution of the enamel, signifying its total destruction. So, this theory is the backbone of the current knowledge of understanding the etiology of the dental caries. Next, I will explain you how this theory implicates the role of the carbohydrates, microorganisms, acids, and dental plaque. Role of the carbohydrates. Karyogenicity of dietary carbohydrate varies with frequency of ingestion, physical form, chemical composition, route of administration, and presence of other food substituents. If frequency of ingestion of carbohydrate increases, frequency of caries also increases. Sticky solid carbohydrates are more caries producing as compared to liquids. Carbohydrates in detergent foods are less cariogenic. Meals with fat, protein, or salt reduce the chances of the caries. And refined pure carbohydrates are more caries producing. Then crude carbohydrates. Next, role of microorganisms. It is uniformly agreed that caries cannot occur without microorganisms. Several organisms have been found capable of inducing caries lesions. A wide variety of organisms are able to initiate pit and fissure caries. Limited number of organisms have proved to colonize smooth surface caries, in which Streptococcus mutans is very significant. Some of the organisms involved in root caries. Mainly Streptococcus mutans play very important role to facilitate in caries formation. It can readily ferment dietary carbohydrate to produce lactic acid. It can synthesize dextran from sucrose. The latter helps in adhering the bacteria as well as acid on the tooth surface. It has ability to adhere and grow even on hard and smooth surface of teeth. Next, role of acids. Acid play a most important role in pathogenesis of dental caries. Critical pH is 5.5. Below this pH, demineralization of tooth substance begins. And last factor of this theory is role of plaque. Plaque is the soft, non-mineralized bacterial deposit which forms on teeth and dental processes that are not adequately cleaned. Plaque prevents the escape of the acid into the saliva and protects acid from buffering action of saliva due to its diffusion limiting properties. Plaque takes almost 2 weeks to mature, but there is considerable site-to-site variation in its composition. Next theory is proteolytic theory. This theory says that caries is essentially a proteolytic process. The microorganisms invade the organic pathways and destroy them in their advance. Acid formation accompanied proteolysis. So according to this theory, there has been evidence that the organic portion of the tooth plays an important role in development of dental caries. There are some enamel structures which are made up of organic materials such as enamel lamellae and enamel rods. These structures prove to be the pathways for the advancing microorganisms. Next theory is proteolysis chelation theory. According to this theory, simultaneous microbial degradation of organic components and dissolution of the minerals of the tooth by the process known as chelation. So the proteolysis chelation theory resolved the argument as to whether the initial attack of dental caries is on the organic or inorganic portion of enamel by stating that both may be attacked simultaneously. Each of these theories failed to explain all ramifications of the disease, but all new theories agree for the factors necessary for dental caries, that is host, flora and substrate. First factor is tooth. Composition, morphology and position of the tooth determines the caries susceptibility or caries immunity. Then role of saliva. Saliva has diluting, buffering and remineralization properties. It provides antibacterial, antifungal, antiviral agents. pH of saliva determined by the bicarbonate concentration. Xylene is an arginine peptide, describe pH rise factor present in saliva. In case of salivary gland aplasia and xerostomia, in which salivary flow may entirely lacking, resulting in rampant dental caries. And thick mucinous saliva increases the dental caries. Next, role of diet. Nowadays, modern diet is less fibrous, soft and sticky and mainly composed of refined carbohydrates. So, the frequency of eating fermentable carbohydrate has been strongly associated with dental caries. Factors associated with diet and dental caries include the relative retentiveness of the food, the presence of protective factor in foods such as calcium, phosphate and fluoride, and type of carbohydrate. Complex carbohydrates, for example starch, are less cariogenic than the simple carbohydrate, for example sucrose, glucose and fructose. Next, pathogenesis of the dental caries. There are two main processes occurs in pathogenesis of the dental caries. First is demineralization and second is remineralization. In demineralization, when sugar and other fermentable carbohydrate reach the bacteria which is present in plaque, they form the acids which starts to dissolve the enamel. An early caries lesion occurs due to the loss of calcium and phosphates. And in remineralization, when sugar consumption has increased, saliva can wash away sugars and buffers the acid. Calcium and phosphate can again enter the tooth and the process is strongly facilitated by the fluorides. So, if demineralization wins over the remineralization over time, then cavity formation occurs. This is the process of the pathogenesis. Last is stages of tooth decay. First stage is white spot. In this stage, caries begins with chalky white area due to the loss of calcium and buildup of plaque. Next is enamel decay, in which enamel starts breaking underneath the tooth surface. Then dentine decay. If tooth is left untreated, decay moves to the dentine in this stage. After that, involvement of the pulp, in this pulp is infected with bacteria and the abscess formation is the final stage of the tooth decay. If tooth is untreated, then tooth loss occurs. So friends, today we learned about etiogenesis and pathogenesis of dental caries. My name is Dr. Bindu. Thank you for watching this video. For more videos, subscribe my channel. Seeing you on another video. Bye for now.